The Senate minority defends its move to release a separate report about the sugar importation fiasco. Its leader, Senator Coco Pimentel, says they disagree with the findings of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee. In their report, Senators Pimentel and Risa Ontiveros said the signatories of a botched sugar importation plan acted in good faith. They also contradicted the Senate panel's decision to clear Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez from the controversy.
Linagay namin yung sarili namin sa sitwasyon ng apat. Sa mata nila, number one, urgent yung sugar crisis. Taas ng presyo ng asukal, may hawak silang datos, kita naman nila talaga mayroong shortage. Tapos sinabihan din naman sila na urgent, tapos nagbibigay naman sila ng update doon sa Malacanang, sa Office of the Executive Secretary, na update naman nila ng mabuti. So para sa amin, may good faith. Kung merong good faith, at medyo pumutok yung issue dahil sa miscommunication o kulang sa koordinasyon, wag na tayo magpalusot na kasuhan niya mga yan, mga anti-graft, kasuhan niya mga yan. Meron pang kinapakaso na smuggling, tanda, alam ba natin na non-billable yun, ganun kabigat yun ha.
The SRA also issues an order allocating all locally produced sugar for domestic consumption. Sugar Order Number 1 covers the current crop year, which will last until the end of August 2023. 1.8 million metric tons of raw sugar are expected to be produced during this period. The order was signed by Philippine President and Agriculture Secretary Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Agriculture Undersecretary Domingo Panganiban, and three SRA officials, including Acting Administrator David Tadeos Alba. The SRA is in charge of classifying locally produced sugar for U.S. quota, for domestic consumption, for reserve, or for the world market. After much controversy, the Philippines pushes through with its sugar importation plan. The Sugar Regulatory Administration formally authorized the importation of 150,000 metric tons of refined sugar. Under the order, the imported sugar must arrive in the Philippines on or before November 15. Half of it will be used for industrial use, while the other half will be for consumers. Sugar importation has been a hot topic after a botched plan to import 300,000 metric tons of the commodity led to congressional investigations and resignations of SRA officials. The former head of the Sugar Regulatory Administration welcomes the Senate Minority Report on the sugar probe. Hermenegildo Serafica thanks Senators Pimentel and Ontiveros, saying they clearly see the data and the evidence he submitted in his defense. He insists he and the other sugar regulatory officials were only doing their duties and had done nothing wrong. The camp of Vice President Duterte denies using a government helicopter to fly home to Davao daily. On Tuesday, Duterte posted a birthday greeting for Marcos, thanking him for letting her use the presidential helicopter, which allows her to be home in time to tuck her children to bed. This post drew criticisms online, with social media users assuming she's going home to Davao on a daily basis. Others call it a disgusting display of privilege. But Duterte's spokesperson says the vice president's family is now based in Manila, clarifying she only uses the helicopter for official work.